everybody. Welcome to another 1132 Kids Online Experience. My name is Mr. Andrew.
And I'm Miss Allison.
And we have a question for you and for you. All right? Would you rather have the tail of a beaver or the tail of a monkey? I know, it's a life question.
That's so easy.
What?
A monkey tail.
What? Why would you have a monkey tail?
Do you know how much easier it would be for me to climb a tree? I wouldn't have to reach all the way up to reach the branches that my arms are so small. I could just grab it with my tail and like jump all the way to the top of the tree. And then I would rule over all the forests.
Okay, I kind of can see that. That's kind of cool. Yeah. But you're wrong.
Excuse me?
Yes, beaver tail would be amazing. You know what you can do if you ever go and play tennis and forget your racket? You've got a racket attached to you. Right? And then, on top of it, if you ever get too hot, you can fan yourself off. The possibilities are literally endless. Yeah. It's unbelievable. Right. But I want you guys to answer the same question, okay? Would you rather have a monkey tail or the tail of a beaver? Make sure you answer in the comment section down below.
And while you're commenting that you would much rather have a monkey tail than a beaver tail, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And just in case you're ever curious about all the weird, fun stuff that goes on behind the scenes, make sure you follow us at our Instagram account at 1132kids. And then after you follow us on Instagram, make sure you head over to church1132.com/resources. And we have so many fun things like 20 things to do at home while you're bored. And we also have resource pages for all of you parents that go along with all of our Sunday services, both for nursery and elementary.
That's right. It is an amazing resource. Well, we're so excited that you guys tuned in today, and Miss Amber has an amazing word for you guys. All right, so let's tune in.
Hi, everybody. It's Miss Amber here again. I'm so excited to be with you guys again this week in your homes. Welcome to another episode of Kids Church Online. Today, we're starting a brand new series. We're having a series called Foundation Lessons. Now, it's called Foundation Lessons because it's all based on the scripture that our church gets its name from, which is Daniel 11:32. This verse says, "But the people that know their God shall be strong and do great exploits." Now, in Kids Church, instead of exploits, that's a really big word, we say do big things. So today we are going to learn all about how we can know God. So knowing God is just like knowing really anyone else. There are three steps to relationship. So 1, 2, 3. The first step to relationship is to meet someone. We have to meet God. We can encounter him for the very first time. Now, when we meet someone, usually the only thing that we know about them is things that maybe other people have told us about them or just things that we've maybe seen from a distance. And sometimes our relationship with God starts at that first step to meet him. Sometimes the only thing that we really know about God is the things that other people have told us, maybe things that our parents have told us or shown us, maybe some of the things that we've just read about God's character in his word, but we don't ever want to stay at that very first step just to meet God. It's so important to meet him and encounter him, but there are more steps to knowing God. So that's step number one. I actually have this amazing Bible story that I want you guys to hear about meeting and encountering Jesus. Check it out. Today's Bible story is the account of the woman at the well. One day, Jesus and his disciples were traveling through the land of Samaria. They came to a city where there was a well. The people of that city used the well to get all of their drinking water. Jacob, a leader of the Israelites, God's people, had dug the well long ago. The afternoon was probably sunny and hot. Tired from traveling, Jesus sat down by the well while the disciples went into the town to buy some food. Jesus was all alone, but not for long. A woman who lived in the town came to draw water from the well. This woman had no friends in the town because of the decisions she had been making. She came to draw her water in the middle of the day, hoping that no one would see her. When she arrived at the well, Jesus was waiting there. Jesus asked her, "Can I have a drink?" The woman was surprised. "How is it that you, being a Jew, asked a drink from me, a Samaritan woman?" she said. See, in those days, Jews were not friends with Samaritans. She was probably only even more surprised when Jesus said, "If you only knew who I was, you would be asking me for living water." The woman said to Jesus, "Sir, you have nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. Where then do you get that living water? Whoever drinks of this water will thirst again," Jesus told the woman. "But whoever drinks of the water that I will give will never thirst again. The water that I give will become a fountain of water springing up into everlasting life." "Sir, give me this water," the woman said. The woman soon discovered that this man, Jesus, knew everything about her life, even the mistakes she had made. She said, "Sir, you must be a prophet. Soon the one is coming who they call the Messiah, the one who will save us." Jesus looked at her and said, "I am the Messiah." The woman was so excited, she set down her bucket and ran into the town to tell everyone who lives there what she just heard. They all came out of their houses and ran down to the well. The woman explained to all the people that Jesus was God's son, the Messiah, the one who came to save them. Many, many Samaritans rejoiced and began to follow Jesus that day. Wow, that was amazing. See, we need to know God. And the woman at the well had a need. Now, her need was, she just needed some water. But Jesus will always meet us at our place of need. So what do we need? Do we need healing? Do we need strength? Do we need forgiveness? What is something that we need? Jesus always meets us at our place of need. So remember, there are three steps to relationships. Step number one is to meet, to encounter. The woman at the well encountered Jesus there just doing her everyday thing. We can encounter God in our everyday life. Now, step number two, choose. When we meet someone, then we choose. Do we want to have a relationship with them? Do we want to have a friendship with them? We have to make a choice. Now, knowing God and having a friendship with God is no different. We have to make a choice. Now, I have an idea that's going to help us with this. Okay, so I know all of you know what this is. Most of you aren't playing with this anymore, and especially if you have a younger brother or sister, you might still have one of these toys at home. But that second step, that choosing, is kind of reminds me of this toy. See, this toy has all of these different shapes, but if you're like me sometimes, you might be a little stubborn and you're trying to put the square into the circle spot, but is it gonna work? No, it's not gonna work. See, we are all like this toy. We are all born in sin, is what the Bible says. We're all born with this piece missing. Now, back in the very beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth, he made this amazing garden and he made Adam and Eve. And Adam and Eve made a bad choice one day and they chose to believe the enemy. Remember when they ate the fruit and then sin came into the world, sickness came into the world, death came into the world, all this icky, sad stuff came in. But what happened was, when God created Adam and Eve, he created them with a pure heart. Nothing was missing. But when they made that choice, their heart became sinful. So there was something that was missing. Now, they still loved God, but because of that choice, whenever they had kids, they could only give what they had, which was a sinful heart. And then when their kids had kids, they could only give what they had, which was a sinful heart. And if you keep going and going and going, and when we were born with a sinful heart. See, our sinful heart has a piece missing. It's kind of like this toy. Now, the piece that is missing can only be filled by one thing, Jesus. See, we see that second step is to choose. And sometimes that choice can seem kind of big or maybe scary or kind of intimidating. But there's really good news for us. The good news is this. God already chose us first. See, God chose us when he sent his son, Jesus, to die on the cross for us. And then 3 days later, he rose him from the dead, and he's actually in heaven with God right now. See, God already chose us. So it makes the choosing a little bit easier. But we need to understand that that thing that's missing is Jesus. But sometimes people don't know that, or sometimes we forget that. And so it's kind of like me when I was stubborn trying to play with this toy. It's like we have this spot that only Jesus can fill, but we try and fill it with other things, like this triangle piece, right? Sometimes we try and put other things in that place and try and just make it work. Sometimes that's just friends, or maybe we think that we'll feel complete because of we're really good at sports, or maybe we're really good at school, or maybe we have a lot of stuff. Whatever it is, we try and fill that spot with something else. And when we try and fill that spot with anything other than Jesus, it just doesn't work. It just doesn't fit. So that second step in relationship is to choose. We have to choose Jesus, and we do that through our salvation. We do that through salvation and submission by putting God first. That actually reminds me of one other thing. Can you guys hold on for 1 second? Okay, so I have all of this sand. So each of these colors of sand represent a different way that we spend our time. So those three steps to relationship. Step number one is to meet, right? We encounter God, we meet him, we know about God, and then that second step is to choose. Remember, God already chose us first, but we choose him through salvation and through submission, putting him number one in our lives. And then the third step is this, it's to know. It's like knowing your best friend. You know your best friend really well. You would know what your best friend would want for their birthday. You know their favorite color. You know everything probably there is to know about your best friend. You really know them well. And the way that you really know them well is by spending time. So God is no different. But it's kind of like this. This container right here represents like our week. So like 1 week in our lives. And then all these fun different colors of sand represent how we choose to spend our time. Now, I know as kids, sometimes you don't feel like it's a choice all of the time to do some of these things, but I want to kind of show you how our week fills up. So let's take a look at the first one. This is chores. I'm sure your very favorite thing to do, right? So some of us spend more time than others doing chores, but it's like this. We fill up our week doing things like chores. It's not too much, right? So hopefully you guys are okay with that amount of chores, right? Then the second one is friends. That's awesome. So you spend time maybe hanging out with your friends after school. Maybe your friends come over to your house. You spend time with your friends. So in your week, we give time to our friends. I like to give a lot of time for my friends because they're really important to me. Now, let's look at the next one. Ooh, school. I know, some of you feel like you don't have as much of a choice here, but school is really important and it takes up time in our week. So we fill up our week with school. Very good. Okay, so the next thing, let's take a look at this. Ooh, TV and video games. Some of you gamers out there, maybe the rest of the thing is filled up with this green sand, right? But you spend time watching TV, playing video games, chatting with your friends online. So we fill up our week with that. Then the next thing is, ooh, sports and activities. Some of you guys play some awesome sports. Let me know what kind of sports you play. You guys can comment down below when you're watching this video. I want to know what kind of sports you guys play. So you fill up your week with sports, playing games, practices, and then the next thing is homework. Some of you have more homework than others, but homework is important, just like school is important, and it takes up time. So we have homework, and then let's take a look at this last one, family. Really important, right? Spending time with our family, our mom and dad, hanging out, eating dinner together. It's really important, and that takes up time in our week. So we fill up this jar with family time. Now, This jar looks pretty cool. I'm actually pretty proud of this. I might take this home and put it on my desk. I don't know. But as you can see, our week really fills up. And none of these things are really bad things. None of these things are things that we just shouldn't do. They're all good things. But as our week fills up, we need to realize that how much time or space is left for God. See, in order to really know God, like we really know our best friends or our family, we have to spend time with Him. And that's a choice. It's back to step number two. We have to make the choice to make time for God. See, our memory verse for today is found in James 4:8, and it's really simple. It just says this: come close to God, and God will come close to you. So it doesn't have to be like this crazy big deal that we make of it. We just need to slow down, pause for just a minute every day and say, God, I want to spend some time with you. God, what should I do today? God, I'm so thankful for fill in the blank. There's so much to be thankful for, but we just need to spend some time with God. So come close to God and God will come close to you. So this is our first foundation lesson to know God. Let me pray for us. God, thank you so much for each and every boy and girl that is watching today, watching our kids' church online. God, I just ask that you would just help us to spend more time with you, God. If we're only spending 1 minute with you, God, help us to spend 2 minutes with you every day, God. God, we want to meet you. We choose you, God. And most importantly, we want to know you. We want to be friends. We want to have a relationship with you, God. We love you so much. In Jesus' name, amen. Men. Guys, I'm so excited that you decided to hang out with me a little bit today, and I cannot wait to get to see you guys soon. Have an amazing rest of your day.
Wow, what an amazing message on knowing God.
That's right. I learned today that I can know God. I have to meet Him, I have to choose Him, and then I can truly get to know Him. That's just like our series verse said, which is Daniel 11:32, which says, "For the people who know their God shall be strong and do great exploits." Or in kids' church, we like to say, "Do big things." Now, we had an amazing icebreaker question at the start of this episode. I don't know if you remember it, but I said that I would much rather have a beaver tail than the tail of a monkey. And so I want to know your answer. So what you can do is you can comment down below and let us know, would you rather have the tail of a monkey or the tail of a beaver?
And while you're commenting that you'd much rather have a monkey tail once again, make sure you hit that subscribe button and you hit the notification button at the top, which looks like a little tiny bell.
Bing!
And that way you can get all of our notifications letting you know whenever we drop a new video.
Ooh.
And after that, make sure you go over to our Instagram and give us a follow at 1132kids, and then go over to church1132.com/resources for all of our parent resources that will go along with this message.
That is right. We're so glad that you guys decided to tune in today, and we'll see you next time.